I have some very sad news to share with you guys. Bruni Hopalian, seen right here. He was one of the best coaches in Southern California. A very positive person. Always happy. Always smiling. Always in a good mood. Always making sure you were good. The person that would see you and give you a hug and say that he loves you. Well, unfortunately, this week he passed away from an overdose. Here he is working with his original ways. He has all kinds of very innovative in the way he was coaching. But besides boxing, he was a phenomenal human being. And I'm going to share with you just one story out of many. It was a couple years ago during the holiday season where he was driving and he saw a homeless man with no clothes. And he pulled over and he went and he bought him clothes. And this is in a day and time where we see homeless people and we keep driving. We ignore them and we act like they don't exist. So, Bruni, you will be missed. I know everybody who knows him misses him. Bruni Hopalian is not only a great boxing coach, he has a gym in Simi Valley, California. He's also a great person. In a day and time when everybody's running around spending money, Black Friday sales, he was driving and he saw a man with no clothes on the streets. And he did something that I don't know, that I would hope everybody else would do, but let's face it, few people would do. He saw a man with no clothes. Obviously, the guy is homeless. Not only that he stopped to help, he took the time. He drove to a nearby thrift shop. He bought the guy some clothes, spent time, money. Here's a little clip as he posted it on his social media. Props to Bruni for stepping up and doing something very, very incredible.
This motherfucker. Hey, homie, you all right?
Hey, I'm not, man. Hey, you don't happen to have a pair of fucking shorts? Whatever, or in a shirt?
Man, I'm gonna go get you something right now, bro. You gonna be here for a second?
Shit.
Yeah, I'll be right back. Let me get you something.
Yeah, put me up here. And I'm glad you're here at the end of this journey, bro.
My brother, God bless you, baby.
God bless you too, man.
Now, who's your favorite fighter of all time?
Muhammad Ali, bro. You know, I keep it classic, man. The guy's amazing, not only as a human being, but as a fighter, man.
How about current? Who do you like right now?
Currently, Lomachenko, one of my top favorites. Terrence Crawford. There's a new up-and-coming kid who I'm really looking forward to watching some more of, and that's Josh Kelly, bro. Kid is amazing. I love that kind of movement. People that can pull off stuff like that in a fight, that's what really gets me.
Lomachenko's sparring partners tell me that when they spar him, it's like you spar three Lomachenkos because he moves so much, it's like there are three of them in the ring with you.
I know, man. I heard the same thing, bro. You know, our boy Tevin Farmer sparred with him, too. Yeah, Tevin's doing good things, too, man.
Fighting for the title.
Tevin, I love you, bro. You worked your ass off for this, man. God is going to continue to bless you, bro. You just keep being yourself.
Now, tell everybody where to follow you on Instagram.
On Instagram, it's Bruni_Hopalian. H-O-P-A-L-I-A-N.
And if you guys go to Bruni's Instagram, he does very innovative things. He throws cards at fighters. You have a medicine ball on the wall. Some people don't understand the logic, and they may ridicule it, but it's working. So tell us about some of the techniques you use for your fighters.
Well, you know what? I'm looking at, like, some what I'm cultivating is some, like, next level mitt work, which is a real fight simulation. Not only are you punching, but you're moving and punching. Punches are coming at you, simulating a real fight, man. And that's what I'm getting known for that right now. They're calling me the mitt doctor now. So.